when the man dies? What happens?
Oh, the answer is a lot happens. Oh, she needs a man, we have to cover her.
They simply mean offer her protection outside, not penetrate her. Your late brother's wife, and you should have nothing, no canon knowledge of her.
I think she must have killed him. Take care of the children.
Yeah,
and you know, she's a bad woman. All her daughters are harlots.
Yes.
And this is the beauty of intercultural marriage.
When the man dies.
Yes.
When the man dies, a lot happens. When the head of the household dies, what happens? When the husband dies, what happens? When the male figure who heads the house, when he leaves, he's no more, and he's got properties and things to his name that are supposed to be passed on.
Yes.
What happens?
A lot.
Wow. I feel like you speaking from the perspective of a woman and what you have seen and heard, throw more light. For instance, a man dies, right?
Yes.
And he's got children. And in among the children, he's got sons or a son.
Yes.
What happens?
Well, because of the preference, and we've talked about this in our earlier video, over male child.
Yeah.
When the man dies and there is a male child in his home, it makes things a little bit easier for the widow.
The widow, okay.
It makes things easier in the sense that he will inherit his father's properties from the father's brothers.
Okay.
Where the properties have not been separated.
Okay.
Yet. So if they are sharing the property, they will give to the male child.
Even though the child is still young, they'll still give to the child, right?
Or yes, they will take into account that child.
I see.
They will take into account that child because there's a male.
Okay.
Because one day he will grow and in their belief, he will ask them.
Okay.
Because in the culture where these things are practiced, only a male can question
another male.
Yes.
I see.
Women cannot question you where our father's properties. It's something that is frowned upon because of the way the female child is seen, which we hope things will change because you should be able to stand up for your father and for your father's property, your father's estate or whatever. To ask the brothers, what about that of my father?
But wait a minute. Look, to think about it, right? Does that mean that a man who works for his own properties and have them after his death, it is the brothers or the family that now have to pass on this to the child? Is that a duty of the family?
Where that happens is where the man maybe had his wealth entangled around his brothers.
All right. So kind of like, maybe done a lot of development things with them, but we haven't specified his wife.
Maybe the brothers were, you know, handling the projects.
Projects, okay.
And the brothers know about his businesses more than his wife.
Okay.
When the man dies, they are not going to be smiling and handing things over to the woman.
I see.
A lot of them will deprive her of everything.
True.
And if they are generous, maybe let her have some. But where there is a male child, maybe they'll consider that one day he would ask. You know, so because women are not valued in that regard. It's a shame, but it's a reality. So because of that, even a woman is not entitled to her husband's property because she's a woman. Like we can't
just based on the gender
side. Your father's home you are disinherited, husband's home you are disinherited, except you have a male child. It is a shame. And do you have the same practice where there is a male child
It's definitely the case where a lot of times the males are preferred. And obviously, so when the man dies and then he's got a male child, it's like it's easier for the mother in terms of acquiring her husband's property because because of the sake of that son, things are easily being able to transfer to the son.
Yes. Yeah. What about where there's no male child,
the widow has got no male child.
Yes. What happens?
Oh my goodness. I think it's a whole kind of war that will not even end in the favor of the woman, because
wow.
already a lot of these extended family members or yes. brothers of the widow's late husband
yes.
begin to see that okay, all these women are going to the daughters will all marry out, and as such there will be no boy or male to inherit the thing, so they hold on to the property, and the wife or the widow will never get anything that belonged to the husband.
Wow.
And it's so hard. You know, I mean, few families, even in the Igbo or the Gazi lands, yes. may probably good men, let me say, few families where you have good men may pass it on, may give it to the widow.
Yes.
But a lot of the times, they do not.
You see, it's the same practice in Igbo land.
It does,
where there is no male child. The widow will suffer.
So
the family of the man will fight her.
Wow.
And have female children. In fact, they will call them harlots. They will call them all sorts of names. Even when the woman is still mourning her husband, they will say she is now a harlot.
Wow.
And this has, you know, it has made a lot of women to start, you know, playing dodgy things with their husband's brothers. Just for someone to maybe pray, because these are the men that will...
They're in charge and they will release the property.
Yes, sometimes...
Especially like lands and stuff like that.
She tries to be nice and these niceness become sexual.
Oh my goodness.
And you know, it happens a lot. As we try to deny it.
True, that is yet another part that I can't understand when a man dies.
You know.
A lot of brothers all of a sudden are interested.
Yeah, some of them see it as a way, she needs a man, we have to cover her, or we cannot allow another, you know, her to go to another
man. Yes, cover her does not mean, it simply means offer her protection outside, not penetrate her.
Well, it includes that.
No.
Unfortunately.
That is your brother's, your late brother's wife. And you should have nothing, no kind of knowledge of her.
I think we got a comment.
Comment, yeah.
Someone this asked same us this question.
Yeah.
What happens when the man dies?
Yeah.
It's a big cultural practice, you know, where we are from.
Yeah, it's
a lot. The answer is a lot happens. There was a case,
mm-hmm.
and it's still ongoing.
Okay.
A lady I used to know.
Okay.
I showed you the lady.
Oh, yeah.
I showed her to you. She has three girls. A very young lady. Her husband is late, not even up to five years.
Yeah.
And her husband's family are actually... You
taking
know,
her on legally
to court, and
because she wants to have the estates of her late husband.
Yeah, she wants things from her husband, and you know, according to her, they had split the inheritance. They did not give her anything, and I think the only reason I can say is because she did not have a male child, and she's female. And they will tell you everything bad about the woman. It still does not justify you denying
the man's children,
yes,
which are those three daughters,
yes,
and his wife, their rights,
absolutely. It will never justify
it, doesn't, yeah,
but it's a practice that we have in our
very common among our culture, yes.
And you know, the whole community will turn against the woman, she's a bad woman, her daughters are harlots because she, you know, she did not,
they might even say she herself is a harlot, or she even killed her husband,
yeah. They say, and when you ask about your husband's property, they say, she's asking. Mm-hmm. She must have killed him.
Yeah.
She must have killed him. That's why she's asking.
Yeah.
You know, most times the woman is left without protection. Unfortunately.
Yes.
And even when the court holds for her,
getting the items to is even another thing.
Enforcing it is a whole different thing. Even women in certain families, mm-hmm. in some families, fight their brother's wives because their brother's wife did not have a male child.
That's appalling.
It's a shame. There's women fighting women. But you know, things are changing. Men are becoming wiser.
Yes.
Where their women know about their
wives usually would know about these investments.
Their wives know about their investments, mm-hmm. and things are separated very well in a way that if anything happens, there'll be, you know, funding and there'll be care for the family and for the wife.
Absolutely.
And I think that disinheriting the woman mm-hmm. in her father's home
yes.
and in her husband's home, you know, naturally just causes her to
be left without any support.
And people call her harlot.
Yes, exactly. What? Because she's left at the mercy of others.
Exactly.
You know.
And if she's not going to be a harlot, that's if she's seen with anybody.
Anybody at all, yeah.
Then she would be seeing the husband's brothers. Behind.
Exactly.
The whole lack of value
yes.
for the female child.
It's really appalling. It's
leading really her very to be bad. Maltreated in her husband's home.
And also in her own father's home. Father's and that is why I personally think a lot of men need to begin to do things right in the right way by doing it with their wives rather than with their siblings.
Like
so that once you are married, ahead,
protecting their family.
The Bible says that the man and the woman will leave their parents. And the two will click together as what? Husband mm-hmm. and wives. So at the end of the day, I personally think this whole idea of when a man dies, a lot happen. It has to be reduced to when a man dies, things are already defined.
Yes.
In a sense that when a man is alive in his lifetime, things will be so defined that his children, be it male or females, know what they are entitled to. That the wife knows every single property and penny the husband owns. Particularly, we the men have to begin to help ourselves by including our women in our agenda of whatever that we do, so that we do it together. And so that the women may know all the properties that we have. So that way, when the man dies, the things are already defined.
Yes.
And nobody other than the wife and children should be touching their property. You know, that's why I think once it starts within the family, even when the daughter leaves the home and then a guy comes to marry my daughter and see how much I value her,
yes,
it will continue that way onto the her marital home.
It continues.
But if you don't value your daughter in her own home, where her father's home,
where so when she's going, married, she won't be valued.
Exactly.
And these things I would say is truly, there's a lot of greed.
Yes, attached greed, to yeah,
greed.
Yeah.
And not being contented with what you have.
Absolutely.
So you have this, you have A, and your brother is no more. Oh, I can have all of that.
Yes.
So that, what about the wife? Oh, she can become my wife
too. My wife too.
Oh, yeah. You know? Oh, but you cannot publicly, okay, I'll do it behind.
Behind.
Okay, what about the brother? Oh, I'll take care of the children. Take care of the children.
Yeah.
And you know, all of that just keep taking.
It's
never enough. It's greed.
Yes.
And we hide behind culture
and perpetuate this kind of carnage.
But when a woman is having to choose between losing her husband's inheritance and maybe
sleeping
with a husband's brother. It is a shameful thing.
Yeah.
And most uneducated women are even more vulnerable because they have no other means. So it's really something that still goes back to educating the female child.
Yes.
Giving her the same opportunity to thrive.
Absolutely.
You know, valuing the female child.
Absolutely.
That value will go with her everywhere she goes.
I agree.
As humans, right? We are reviewing all the cultural practices.
Yeah.
Like we sit down and we're reviewing. It's important to us.
It's important. It is.
To transfer.
And asking ourselves, is it serving us or we are serving that cultural practice?
To transfer certain culture and practices to our children. And we have exposed to you guys before how similar the Igbo culture and the Dagaba culture
are so alike.
Similar.
Yes.
And you are going to be seeing all of this. And we hope that you have learned so much.
If you are a female child in your family and you feel like you've been discriminated against, we would love to hear from you.